It's been a hard day's
night. Well, it's time for 2022 GGVO. Another scratch build for me this year. I may do two like I did last year. I'm not sure yet about the second one. And what I've decided to do is to build a Tuttenbacher. I'm Steve Tuttle. I'm going to build a Tuttenbacher, as you can see over my head here. I have a couple of Rickenbackers. The black one here is a 330 12 string my wife gave me when we got married in 1979. So it's a really nice Rick. And this one's a late 90s 360 six string. And I like them a lot. I've played, but never owned a small Rick, with the East Coast 3/4 Rick. It's a 315 through 325 series, like Lennon used to play. And as you can see here, I have an empty hook right here between these two Ricks. And so I think I'm going to make one the way I want to, with the small body, but quite a bit different. It won't be the same construction as regular Rickenbackers, or Rickenbackers. I'm sorry, you're going to catch me saying it both ways. I'm sure I think they pronounce it Rickenbacker, but oh well. These are a few of the other guitars I've made in the past that I've kept. If you guys watched any of my stuff last year, you know that the main one I built last year was for Guitars for Vets. This guitar is going to be for me. The next one I build, and I may film if I have time to finish it by the time GGBO is done, is also going to be for Guitars for Vets. Generally, I'm able to build about three a year. And two of them go to Guitars for Vets, and I try to keep one. And there's a few on the wall behind the camera that you don't see that I have too. So, anyway, gonna try to fill this slot up with another Rick inspired type instrument anyway. And my plan is to use all Rickenbacker electronics, same types of electronics, same switches. I'm going to use their pickups, their tailpiece, their bridge. And I'm hoping that, even though the construction is going to be a little bit different, is going to give me that Rick sound that I'm looking for. We're just going to have to see how it goes. I'm going to have to get started. I've actually had this guitar in mind for many, many years. I have a few sketches down, but I haven't got anything like a plan. So I'm going to have to work on the plan real quick, come up with that, and then get started. And you can see I've got, like I said, I've got room for it. So, well, I always have room for another guitar. That's not a problem. I got two empty walls here. So, you know, we'll see how it goes. But hopefully it'll turn out good. It's going to be mostly maple construction. A few odd things thrown in, and we'll see how it goes after we get the drawing put together. Okay, let's go. GGBO 2022. So here it is, sketch out of something similar to a Rickenbacker, drawn out to scale. Always a good idea to do a scale drawing. I've got the side too. I have put together a jig to hold this to cut the tapers. Well, finished cutting the wedge of patoot cap for the center, and been gluing up all night. I decided to go with a little edge of walnut around the patoot. So anyway, we'll undo it up here and see what we got. And
here we go. It's a little hard to pick.
So I decided to go with 24 because the easiest thing to do to get 24 is take one that's cut for a 25 and a half. If you cut off the first fret, you end up with a scale length of 24.07, close enough to 24. So I marked out the wings, the body wings, and so I'm gonna just rough cut them right now to get things going. They have had the walnut and padauk added to them for the proper width. And so I finished cutting the shape in the wings. Got them marked for where they'll be chambered out. This also has a mark on it for where there'll be access from the back with the cover. There we go. Put it all together. Starting to look like a Tuttenbacher. So here's the binding on the neck, all taped on, waiting for the glue to set up, and then we'll trim it all to fit, and goes good with the tiger maple sides. Little decorative leave here of the fretboard material right there. So got the tape off, everything looks pretty good, glue up looks good. These are a little proud since I just cut on the table saw there, so I'm going to take it down a little bit with the block plane and then get this in a little more shape for you to see it nice and flat. So with the dots, the fretboard dots, I'm going to use these mosaic pins like they use on knives. Hard to see in the camera, here's the quarter inch one. Kind of see that, there's an eighth inch I'm putting in here, use the quarters for the 12th fret. Yeah. Drilled out and test fitted the tuners, everything looks pretty good. Locking shallers on there. It's going to come out pretty sweet, I think. See if you've got any scratches or anything you couldn't see at the last minute putting the light, but there it is. Not bad. A lot of work, not bad. Cool. So it's time to glue the wings on. And what I'm going to do is I saved these cutouts from the body blank, and I will use those as calls to help the clamps keep this in place. And so I'm going to go ahead and try to get it glued up. Keep that clamped up for the rest of the day, likely.
So, as you can see, what I've done is I've made myself a construction paper, thick, very thick cardboard, fitting here around the neck so that I can cut Well, I don't have time to glue it together yet, but here's the template. So I can put that on there to cut the top, the notch for the neck.
Okay, so I've cut the notch in here. Remember, this part is actually waste because the neck pickup will go right up, right along there, about out part of that. So let's see how we go here. We are on the center line, and we are nice and tight. Where the trapeze tailpiece goes and comes up at an angle. So, time to put a finish on it. And this year I thought I would try the wipe-on guitar finishing lacquer from Crimson. So, put several coats of the Crimson Guitar's water-based wipe-on lacquer. And I've been polishing it up by hand. I used I did a 800 grit super Aslix up to 1200. Then I did some Abralon pads up to 4000. And then I used Stumax medium fine, and finally just finished putting on the swirl remover. And so I left the neck at about 2000, so it's got a satin finish on it. I did not grain fill the Paduke. I wanted to see how it came without. I kind of like it. You can feel it, but that's okay. That's good. So I'm starting to wire this beast up. I've got my wiring diagram. I also have some pictures of what the wiring looks like. So I'm not very good at wiring it. It's very frustrating. So for me anyway. So I'm going to get started on it and hopefully bring you back and film the final product that's in better shape. So here is the wiring harness I've got so far. Backside. I think I got it all in place. Now I gotta do is stick it in the guitar, wire up the pickups and the jack, and we'll see if it works. Well, after finding one missing wire, everything else went pretty good. The install looks fairly tidy, at least for me. Nut finished.
through, yeah? Shiny. Comfortable. Blowing in now. Just a little bit of blue. I got it all set up. Got the string hat where I want it. Bridge where I want it. Everybody's happy. It's been a good GGBO 2022 for me. I got to build my guitar I've wanted to build for several years. Yes, it should be a Tuttenbacker because it should be a Rickenbacker. I know, keep telling me that. So I'm old, forgive me. But it's done, and I composed a little ditty to play to demo the guitar. I'm not a musician either, as well as not a videographer and so forth, but. Guitar sounds good, plays good, stays in tune, just exactly what I wanted. So here's to the end of my GGBO 2022 this year, and good luck to everybody else. I've enjoyed watching so many videos, and continue watching and see what happens to the end in all the categories. Thanks.